Hi mommies and daddies, welcome back to Momcom India. So in this video, I'm going to answer a lot of your questions about the teething journey or the teething process that a baby undergoes. I have already done a separate video on how can you help a baby during the teething process. So if that's something that you're looking for, then the link to that video will be in the description box or towards the end of the video. In this video, I will more talk about my experience about when does the baby start getting teeth, what is the order in which the teeth start coming, what is the normal cycle of one tooth to erupt. So all of those questions is what I'm trying to answer in this video. Let's get started.
To watch all the videos on this channel, click on the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get regular updates from Momcom India. Let's become a big fat family soon.
Before I start this video, my request, if you find this to be helpful, please click on the like button. And if you subscribe to our channel by clicking on the red button below, don't forget to hit the bell icon. Otherwise, you won't get a notification whenever we post a video. So my regular viewers know that my son is now 16 months old. He already has 10 teeth and he's about to get the next two. I'm already able to see that. So I think by now I have a lot of experience about the entire journey that he's undergone and my research about the entire teething process. So I'll try to answer all the questions that I've read of yours for understanding of the teething process. So the first thing that we need to know is that the first set of teeth that a baby gets in his life are known as milky teeth, baby teeth, or primary teeth. This whole set of primary teeth consists of 20 teeth that the child will get between the age of 3 months. It can be as early as 3 months and up to 36 months. So it's a long journey during which the entire set of 20 teeth will erupt in the child's mouth. Now, as a parent, something that I found out, something that I did not know of was that, you know, all the effort and all the pain that the child goes through in getting these primary teeth goes all in vain because all of these teeth are going to fall off so that the child can get his permanent teeth, which will start happening between the age of 6 to 14 years. So the teeth that will come at that time when the primary teeth fall and they are replaced by new teeth are called the permanent teeth, which then will continue with the child throughout his life. The second question normally that's asked is that what is the general timeline for the teeth to start coming? My baby is around 3.5 months. I see my baby drooling a lot or trying to put things in the mouth. Can it be teething? Is it not too early? So actually, it's not too early. The normal guideline is that, you know, your first tooth erupts between 6 to 8 months, but there are always exceptions, and the exceptions say, or what is seen in the exceptions is that some babies have got their first tooth between the age of 3 to 6 months also. So that's why the whole cycle that I would say, you know, falls in the teething process is 3 months to 36 months. So the next question that's asked is that what is the entire duration of a tooth to erupt? So in my experience, the entire duration is about 8 to 10 days from the day when your gums start to swell. So for me, when the gums start to swell or they become red or they, you know, it becomes irritable, that's day one when the gums have basically started preparing for the tooth to erupt. From that day till about day 5 is when the tooth erupts. You know, you suddenly will be able to see the layer of the tooth, you know, very clearly on the gum, and suddenly the tooth will erupt. But it does not mean that the process has ended. It will take about 3 to 4, it could be 5 days also, for the tooth to come out, you know, properly. So for me, the whole eruption cycle is a 8 to 10 day cycle, during which you should take a lot of care, especially in terms of hygiene, so that the baby does not fall sick. The third question that's asked is that my baby is between 10 to 12 months. Is it possible that he's not got his first tooth yet? So, you know, if I was to tell you that yes, there are always exceptions, it is possible, but let the doctors confirm that. If you have crossed a 10 month timeline and still your baby does not have his first tooth, or, you know, first at least 2 teeth, then you should be consulting a doctor and let them do an assessment of whether everything is going fine or not. In some cases, there is a possibility that there's some nutrition that the body is missing, because of which, you know, the body is finding it difficult to get into the entire teething process. So let the doctors assess that. So if you've hit 10 month, no tooth, consult the doctor. The fourth question question is that what are the most common signs of teething? Although this is something also that I've covered in my other video, but just for this video, I'll quickly cover them. One is drooling. You know, the child takes out a lot of saliva or takes in a lot of saliva. So that's one common symptom that you'll see. Second is the willingness to chew anything and everything that the child is getting. It could be his finger, it could be his thumb, it could be just anything that the child is able to grab. Number three is irritability. There's a general irritability. The child is unable to express, you know, what he's going through, and, you know, just does not feel like being what he or she normally is. Could be a very fussy. At that time, the whole hunger goes through an entire change. You know, the child might not feel like eating the things that he generally likes, might want a complete different texture of food. So, you know, those are things that you should be cautious of. It is also a time when the child's body temperature is slightly higher. I won't call it fever, but I'll say that the body generally feels slightly hot compared to, you know, the other days, because the body is doing a lot of work to erupt that tooth. It is also important for you to break the myth that teething is associated with fever and loose motions. That's absolutely not the case. That is a result of the child taking in a lot of bacteria because of putting a lot of things in his mouth, because of which all these infections can occur. So whenever, although I suggest that you should take care of hygiene all the time, but especially during teething process, you should be extra cautious about hygiene, because that is the time that the child can fall sick very, very easily. So now let's understand the entire teething schedule. I think it's very important to understand what tooth is going to erupt when, because you will be able to help your child or give solutions to your child for the teething pain according to that age also. So I think I, as a parent, have been very keen to understand the entire schedule, and that has helped me a lot also, because my son is almost on that schedule only. So let's get started on that. So what you see on the screen now is a beautiful chart which explains the baby teething order. So like I said, that this primary teeth or baby teeth is a set of 20 teeth. We can break this set down into 5 subsets. So basically, central incisors, lateral incisor, canine, first molar and second molar. These are 5 sets. Each set has 4 teeth. So 5 multiplied by 4, it's a total of 20 teeth that the child will get between 3 months to 36 months of age. Now let's start understanding when does what tooth erupt. A disclaimer is that don't take it as a rule. This is just a guideline. Each baby is different. You will see that for your child, maybe first the bottom tooth came, then the upper tooth came, and vice versa, or one tooth came and the other tooth came quite later. So just don't go get into those kind of details. Just take it as a basic understanding of how the guideline or the chart is. So now let's understand the order. So the first set to appear will be central incisor, which is the red circle. So like you see that between 6 to 10 months, the lower central incisor appeared, and between 8 to 12 months, the upper central incisor appeared. So this whole cycle will be 6 to 12 months, between which the child is supposed to get about 4 teeth, which is the upper and the lower central incisor. Then the second set to appear is lateral incisor. So like you see the orange circle, between 9 to 13 months, the upper lateral incisor appeared, and between 10 to 16 months, the lower lateral incisor appeared. So again, the window for lateral incisor, which is right next to the central incisor, is between 9 to 16 months for all the 4 teeth to appear. So between 13 to 19 months, you see the upper first molar, and between 14 to 18 months, you see the lower first molar. So anywhere between 13 to 18 months, the child gets his first molars. Then is the canines. So if you look at it, between 16 to 22 months, the green circle, the canines, which are the sharp teeth, they appear, and between 17 to 23 months, the lower canines appear. Canines and first molars are generally the most painful teeth to come. So this is the time that you'll have to have a lot of patience and encourage the child quite a lot. So that is about it till about 2 years. The last set to appear is the second molar, which is the purple circle, which comes anywhere between a 23 month to a 33 month. Like you see, the purple circle lower second molar appeared, and the purple circle upper second molar appeared. So as per this chart, the start was about 6 months and the end was about 33 months, but exceptions to the rule, change it to a 3 months to a 36 months for all these teeth to appear. I hope you found this colorful chart to be interesting also. It's a good read, it's a good understanding, and it's a good to know information. So I wanted to share what I have learned with you too. I hope you enjoy the teething process with your child by engaging them. I think that's the best thing to do. A lot of doctors encourage not to do anything but engage the child during this process, because it's a natural process. The child's body has the immunity, has the strength to fight it and get it out, and that's how strong we need to make our children also. So with that said, I will end the video by saying that do like if you did like it, do comment if you have any more questions, but I would definitely suggest that if you are asking for solutions, refer to that video, share it with as many friends as you can, and definitely subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for always watching and loving MomCom India.